Discussion session at the end of these whole presentations. So I would like to call a close friend of mine from Vietnam to tell us his side of the story. Tuan Mami, born 1981, Hanoi, Vietnam. He's been working in these institutions or collective or projects as well that they call as Mobile Art Center in 2012, and then later on he is now the creative director of Nasan Collective Art Space in Hanoi, which was established in 2013. I think I would like to, are you ready, Mami? All right, we will listen to Tuan Mami presentations about the collective as well as their projects, and sometimes probably in some of the projects mingle with his own artistic practice, his own works. Please.
Thank you everyone to come here in the very early moment. Thank you very much Farah and Ava and Abtok to give me a chance to present our practice in Georgia. And especially I'm very happy to be back here. I love the art scene in Georgia and also love the art spirit of the people here. It's very special for me. To be part of the discussion about how to empower the art scene. I was thinking a lot about what is the strategy of our art scene, also our art collective. So I didn't know and never questioned about what is our strategy. But then when I look back and then I decide to so-called it is an art of survival, because for me, it's, we have no strategy, but to survive is our strategy to make art. So, today, because of the limitation of the time, so I just speak very briefly about what happened in Hanoi and what's going on with the art scene nowadays, and what do we do with the collective. So to make more sense for the word survival, I should, because before to make the word, I did some kind of looking back to the history and what's going on with our art community. So I found some image that is really inspired me. So during the war, many activity of the people to again with the government, American period. So the image of the monk is very famous. His name is Thich Quảng Đức. He suicide, burned himself to make a message to again the political strategy of government. But for me, it presents a lot of how we are doing nowadays to stand on our own voice. And then later on in the 70s, after the war finished, we still have to survive. The new government building up very strictly system. So it's for a lot of thousands of people have to run away of country. And if you have like the people still call it the boat people, because the thousands of people have dead during their trip. And then the dark straight to the dark drama is not finished yet, until the 80s. The new government, the communist government, they like even being harder and being smarter strictly to control the people, the population in Vietnam. And they build up many law, like so-called cultural rule, that even you see the image, the guy who got caught because of the cram dancing, because he danced, that is like illegal for the Vietnamese culture. So all very briefly cultural history that still relate to our lives today. So then we have the big, very big event in 1986, when the first time government agreed to open the country to have the like renovative period, the so-called Đổi Mới, is something people, the government start to let people do business. It's the first time you can own your business. The first time you can own your property. The first time you can speak on your own voice. Before, everything had to go through the filter of the government. So because of that, we start to have the chance to know about the war outside of Vietnam, outside of communism. Then the first time we can reach the some books like that is not belong to the communists, not belong to the government filter. Then in the 90s, is our very booming period when like many business to be very successful, because you know many other countries really like Korea to know like what's going on in the country. So it's something like lift the country up, and then also give many artists the chance to explore the new new art form. So in 1998, Nyasan Studio, where I'm still working on and we still working on, established by two third generation of contemporary art in Vietnam. They are like, one is the owner of the building, Nguyễn Mạnh Đức and Trần Lương, who is the artist. So they established the first independent artist run experimental art space in Vietnam. So I can introduce very quickly some image. So because of even the country is open, but it's still very under strictly controlled by government. So to make something like not like indirect through government, it's still very hard to make build our name. So the good strategy that we they build the aspect in their own house. So this is the original house, and it is in the very far of the center. So it's a very good place to keep the activities. So Nyasan Studio like run over like over 10 years, since 1998 until 2010. And then you can see in the picture, it is the first is we call it the Artist House. because the house, the space, always open for every art lover, every artist who love to know about the new art form, to experience the different like philosophy of art. And then during the times, we did so many like experimental because because at that time in Vietnam is booming of the art market. So many artists getting very rich because of the business. Seem like very like totally like the art contemporary practice or like something like experimental art. So we are. We were just focusing on like how to develop the art form, how to promote the experimental direction. So we host all kind of like interdisciplinary art, like installation, like contemporary performance. So almost of the new art form was born in underneath the Nha San studio in Vietnam. And then, unfortunately, 2010, we have the, at that time we getting quite famous, well known in the art scene in Hanoi. And then, every event we have a very big number of audience, and then it making trouble. 2010, we did an in-act festival, is an international performance festival. And then one of the work in the festival is by Lai Thị Diệu Hà. She did the first naked performance in public. So that like turned the government to be very upset about us. And then they raised up the question about the culture and then the moral of art and what is the good form for the Vietnamese people. And then they decide to close down. They started they just close it down by no reason. And then they force you to stop. Then we lost our space since 2010. But I think the spirit of the art space is we never been in an institution or aspect is every activity there is shared by people, by artists, friends, because the hall is open, so everyone can come and then we just need to follow the direction of like how to make the new art form. So I am the very young generation, so some kind of like the third generation in the contemporary art in Vietnam. So we were thinking that like we can't stop. We have to keep the work going on because until now we are still the only like experimental non-profit art space in Hanoi. So the big question is how to make it without the physical space, without the space. So we just like some young artists, we gather together and discuss about how to continue the work. And then at that time is a very sensitive time of the like situation because every artist from Nha San was under like control. Like really, they really like follow us to see like to control the activities. Then 2011, we after like few months of the closing, we decided to make an event called Skylights Without Flying People. That is the first chapter of the like our mobile art space. So we decided to base the event in London in 2011. That we work with the gallery in London. And then that chapter like to take us to the next step that in 2012 we built very important project called Skylights with Flying People. So it's one more time to kind of like reset ourselves that we are here and we are like proud ourselves. We will be prepared to keep doing our art. So the strategy of our chapter 2 is more like temporary and guerrilla project. And all the things we are like ready to fail with everything. So what did we do? We think the situation like is very hard, but we need to come back to Hanoi to build up the art scene to continue to make the art. So we have to transform. So we decide to work with the Sapen Foundation Hanoi, and then we ask them to borrow the space, just space, and then we transform. This is the original space of the Sapen Foundation. So we borrow their space in 3 months, and then what did we do? We transformed the office of the Sapen Foundation to be the very temporary artistic art space, and then include like 7 studio, 2 exhibition halls, and 1 of the information center. So we work with the artist, invite artists to work with us in the temporary project that we build the studio to fit in the need of artists. That is very important for us because in Vietnam, we never think about what the need of artists. So what, you know, we really build the space for the need of the art. So you can see some of our project, like the Black Room is our mini theater, or like that to present all kind of like alternative theater and experimental theater, very small, but you can free then you can. But the more important of this project that we are there, we are living there, working there every day. We don't call ourselves as an exhibition because it's really hard to get the permission from the government. It's almost like no opportunity to get the permission. So we just call it a project, and then we living, working there every day from morning to evening, and then we asking people to come to discuss with us, we talk with us, and then the work like kind of like processing presentation. So I also built a project called Mark Hanoi, something like a mobile art space, art center. That is, I host all kind of research project from our proposal. So all of the art talk and artwork that is not allowed to show in the event, so we just present in the small room. So the project Skyline with Flying People really give us some idea of how we can make the next step. So in 2013, last year, we decided to found Nha San Collective, that is like transforming of Nha San Studio. But it's still like the growing of Nha San. So the main member of the collective, we have 9 artists who like working like long time together from like over 10 years. So we just decide to like, we need the more like support, more energy. So we decide to gather, and we decide to share everything, share the work, share the money to rent the space. So we occupy one of the abandoned pharmacy factory in the city, that we transform the old factory to be the temporary art space. So whole the concept of the collective is the open group, that we are not fixed artists. We are not like close the collective. We are there to welcome more people. We need more people to be part of our collective. So far until now, we have around 15 artists being our member. So we also not only working with artists, we also welcome like outside curator and you know the assistant to working with to build the net. We call it the net, and then we base the collective on the project project made. So it's the very beginning, and then you know we did some like many project by our curator, also from curator outside. So this is some of the project that is very site specific. We also hold many art talk and workshop, but the unfortunately one again the space lasts only for 6 months. After that, the government like closed the space down, so we lost again. But still, we feel that it's not bad at all. In 6 months, we know that it's very temporary. It's very kind of like non-stable. So we did many projects there. Like we in 6 months we did like 11 occasional event and then 2 big festival, international festival. And then after the loss of the space, we continue with the idea of mobile art center that we are not stop. We keep doing our art projects. That we spread it around Hanoi, and we work with different aspects because somehow we feel it's really important, and it's kind of like the only way you can survive. That is building the network to support for each other, and then. We just go all around the Spain, Hanoi to borrow to base our event, and then also we come back to the old studio with the, like sometimes we make a party and then to welcome people, but it's not serious in the serious way, but it's the way of like possible. And then after that, early of this year, because the biggest question is we need to be continue, we need to survive, we need to kind of like build up the art in there. Our biggest question is we have a lot of artists in Hanoi. We have a lot of aspects, but we never been considered as we have the art scene there because everyone like very, like working very quiet. Everyone don't want to working together because you know the many reasons. So we earlier this year we found another space and then trying to reform Nyasan Collective. And with the new strategy that is, we think is like is more fit to the situation. So we call it the hiding and rebuilding strategy. So this is a new aspect. It's not yeah, but we are under construction. And what do we do with the new art strategy? Is we hide ourselves in the coffee. And then we're working with some kind of commercial environment that and then one hand we establish as the art center with all the legally paper and lessons, and then the other hand we working with the art cafe to running our like illegal so-called illegal event that is new. We know the event like performance event or some like sensitive video or even installation is like almost no chance to get permission. So we like find the fit space to work with. But we need, you know, like both sides of like of the form, like one is illegal, one is legally, to keep our collective going. And then the other thing I want to share that we are going to start with a new artist in residency. That is the first artist, I believe that is the first artist in residency in Hanoi. So I hope after that we can make more like connection. That was always my dream to bring artists from outside to Vietnam to build up like bigger network. So the last strategy for me, which we are doing now, is building the network and new opportunity. So we, like in last a few months, we run around all the places, all the institutions of the, like even university, to ask for the opportunity to like to see the how we can create the new relationship with different variety institution. So far we got many good confirmation from them for the next some big projects. So we hope one hand we can, you know, survive very legally, and we only that way we can have and we can build a scene. We can have our own audience that is like it's somehow like we until now we don't call our audience is like kind of art lover because they very up and down because the art is not like in the good promotion, so people like very afraid and also always kind of like stay one step backward to touch the art scene. So it's not like they kind of like negative to be in the part of the art scene, so we want to change it. So that is the reason why we want to build the network that we can say and we can promise our audience that you have the right to participate in the art scene. So and the other thing is I really hope and believe that we can like furthermore we can working together in the like Southeast Asian because I saw so many opportunity and the similarity of the art scene in Southeast Asian. That is really pity if we can't connect, we can't work together. Because, you know, like look back, why? The question is why we, the Southeast Asian art scene, this is always very like, you know, considered as a small like community. So I think to make it to be bigger and stronger is we need more like collaboration. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Mami, for that really insightful information about what you've been doing. Again, here we witness the issues of social political background in which even actually the state agency become the main obstacle of your sustainability. The issues of sustainability of this kind of collective, this kind of initiative, and at the same time, it's somehow proven by what Mami has been doing with his friends in Hanoi. The issues of sustainability somehow can be faced, can be solved in a way by constantly changing your strategy and sort of like evolve in either content, form, ideas, and completely try to respond quickly to whatever situations that they face. So with that small notes, I would like to invite two questions only, not too much, because we will have Mela respond from her side, from her experience, and then we will open like longer, much more vibrant discussions, I hope, with the other presenter later. Two questions, maybe?
My name is Yosef Arizal, and I'm the student of Indonesian Art Institute Yogyakarta. I want to ask, the title of the discussion is Empowered New Relation, Dynamic and Strategies in Contemporary Asian Scan, Art Scan Today. So I want to ask you about how we, Asian artists, show our locality in front of world art to make a differentiation between, different country, different culture. I think it is important to show our local representation. Is there a strategy to empower our art, especially in representing our locality? Okay, thank you.
Thank you for the question. We are still suffering. We are still figuring out how to empower. But as I said, like we really, like our Southeast Asian with many similarities, with the cultural characters, with the natural life, that we have long history being together. And I think to make it like more like appearance, we have to do more like collaborate. We need to build up our like bigger statements for something like the East philosophy of art. Because the as I see is we are working very separate because of economy, because of the conflict in the politics. But that is really, really pity for our scene. If we can do more like sharing, we do more like viewing, more like bigger philosophy of the asking here, or the network and the foundation for the art, I believe we'll leave it off.
One more? Only one. Ladies, sorry about you, but you will get your chance later, I promise.
Hello, I'm Ina from Komunitas Salihara. It's private initiative art center in Jakarta. Your story reminds me a little bit with how our friends from Q Film Festival is doing their festival every year, being in guerrillas and working with other institutions. And I wonder how you managed to do promotion while not promoting your works, your events, exhibitions, and other stuff, because you need to spread the word out, and you need to make sure that people are coming and participating in your events. But at the same time, you have to make sure that the people who are not supposed to be know about your events are knowing when and where it's going to happen. So I'm interested in how you're doing your promotion and not promoting it at the same time.
Thank you. I think that question is our, at the moment, is our biggest question. And then we are building our strategy like around that question too. And that is not easy at all to do and to build a strategy in Vietnam, like particularly in Hanoi, because you might know about something about the kind of like policy of Vietnamese government that is somehow is like kind of, for me, I call is anti-art. Is they somehow don't care about the content, but they care about the art form. They care about something strange that they don't want to accept to the country. So to make it, the last strategy we are building is hiding and rebuilding. But how to do it is also not easy at all. So step by step, the first we are separate our art collective or art center to be the officially center that we can, one hand, we can promote our event, we can get support from people, we can build our community, build our audience that also can support us, can save us. I believe when we have like stronger and more people like around, we can stand on our own voice. Other hand, that also is very conflict question, because if you are appear in the situation, it's kind of like killing your art direction or orientation. But what can we do so far is we making different event, something like underground event, something we don't like promote much. We don't let it appear. We organize in the very flexible way, flexible space and time. So it's more like occasionally, more like, you know, just like very temporary event that like is like run from one to the other. So they come like kind of like you know like tie you up. They come like you know pick you up. Something like we are making the game, like the chasing game. So it's no like clear answer, but it's the strictest.